In this video, I'll first explain how to use Rail Revolve and share a hammer texture pendant example in the second half of the video. Drawing a rail curve. Take a hexagram as an example. Then draw a profile. Just draw half of it. The two control points of the opening need to be aligned. Open the rail tool. On the right, the options control where the surface is generated. Select Generate Above. Select the rail first. Change fixed profile size to no. Change the axis to world center plane. Then select the profile to generate it. Now I will explain how it generates surfaces. Rotate the profile. It puts a profile on every control point of the rail. Then rotate it around the center of the world or the center of the rail to create the surface. Go on to the other options. For the first one, the surface is generated above the rail curve. Like this. Second, the surface is created in the center of the curve. This option is generally used for styles with top and bottom symmetry. Lastly, the surface is generated below the rail. Because it's so rarely used, I'm skipping it. Moving on to the command prompt options. When fixed profile size is on, the profile size is fixed. We can see that the center of the surface have been staggered. This is due to the long length of the profile. The profile is longer than the center of the surface, so it is staggered. When I lengthened it, you can see how the centers have changed. When I shorten it, the profile narrows accordingly. For some specific styles, you can cap it and set the diamonds in the center. Moving on to other options. Per segment count means the number of subdivisions of the profile. Each control point is subdivided by another one. Change it to 1. Then one profile is added between each control point. This is the center of rotation is the center of the world. So no matter where the rail curve is, the center of revolve is always at the center of the world. Change it to rail center. It means the center of revolve is always the center of rail. So no matter where the rail is, the center is always at the center. Next, I'm going to show you how to make a hammered texture pendant. Now let's get started on this pendant. First, draw the rail curve. And then skew the curve. Open up the control points and adjust the shape. Open the edit box. Select the x-axis and y-axis. Change the size to 20. Then draw a profile. Round the corners of the curve. Use Edit Box to change the profile's thickness. Close the X-axis. Change the thickness to 1.1. Use the Rail tool to create a surface. Then use the JFR Bend tool to bend the sheet. Open four directions. Bend a little bit the first time. The second time, use two-way to bend a little more. This makes it look more natural. Find the Split tool. Split the surface to create the hammer texture. And split the middle part. Delete it. Open the Hammer Texture tool. Open up Preview for easier viewing. The position of these edges can be edited directly. Hold Ctrl and left click to create control points. Some positions of the control points can be gathered together. OK to generate. Duplicate the top and bottom borders. Draw a line on the curve. Using Sweep Two Rails, generate the surfaces. Join them together. Now make a chain piercing here. This hole should be a little curved. Generate a round pipe. Scale it with scale 1D. Subtract the hole out with Boolean difference. Finally, smooth it out with the tools we learned before. Quadra mesh. A quantity of 5,000 is enough. Then just give it a material. That's it. That's all for this video. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share this video, and subscribe to us. See you next time.